The Beatles had a good decade with the 60s, but there is a comic book comparison to be made there, and that's what I'm planning on doing right now. I watched, as I'm sure many of you did, the Beatles documentary on Disney Plus a couple weekends ago. I was surprised to sit through the whole 8-hour thing because I'm not necessarily a Beatles guy. I like the music just fine, but when I went to Chicago Comic-Con back in the 2000s and Beatles Fest was going on in the same hotel at the same time, I didn't make fun of them because I was at a comic book convention, so who was I to speak? But I, you know, wasn't going over there to check out the puppet show or anything. I don't know most of the history of the Beatles. I have a general idea of what happened, but I got really sucked into this movie. But while I was watching it, you know, I did a little research on Wikipedia and went back and took a look at the Beatles' list of albums that were released in the 60s. Because, you know, really they were a band for about 10 years in the 1960s. And they worked full time at it and they put out a lot of albums before they inevitably broke up. And I was watching Rick Beato's YouTube channel, which if you like to listen to music theory and discussion of especially the rock and roll era of music, that kind of thing, he does some amazing videos analyzing these kinds of things. I'll leave a link in the show notes to Rick Beato's channel. But he brought up the fact that, well, first, they were all less than 30 when the Beatles broke up, which is triply insane to think of that output in your 20s alone. But second, he pointed out that there was a point between August of 1965 and August of 1966 when the Beatles released, was it three or four out? Four albums total, Help, Rubber Soul, Yesterday and Today, and Revolver. That's an awful lot of songs, first of all. I mean, obviously that first album they had been writing before then, but still, three albums inside of that year plus that fourth at the beginning, if you count those 12 months, you know a lot of the songs that were on those albums, just a ridiculous number of classic all-time songs. And when you think about that with music, I tend to, of course, relate everything back to comics. So I'm thinking, who else has put out that kind of work that quickly? And I knew the answer right away because this is something I had noticed in the past. And that is inevitably Asterix. Asterix started in 1959. It continues on to this day. Volume 39 just came out. But if you look at the sort of the McCartney-Lennon team of Goscinny and Uderzo, they were together. Their most furious period of creation was from about 1959 to 1973 or so. And then Goscinny died in 77, I believe it was. But they were on the racks every week in Pilot Journal. Asterix started off, of course, as a serialized series in Pilote that Goscinny was editing. Uderzo was, I believe, was even art directing it at the beginning. And they just pumped out page after page, a page a week, sometimes 2 pages a week. Maybe there'd be a month off between storylines. I'm imagining while they figured out what the next storyline was going to be and got started on it. But it was an amazing amount of creativity put on the page in one decade. And if you go, so the Beatles era was from 65 to 66 that we're talking about there with the four albums. If you take a look at the Asterix release dates, 1966, they put out three albums in the same year. Now, the series started in 59. They didn't start collecting the albums until 1961. So there's a bit of a head start there, obviously. But Asterix the Gaul came out in 61. Then there's a book in 62, a book in 63, a book in 64. It makes sense. It's a 48-page book. There's 52 weeks in a year. You'd get, you know, one album every year. It's an annual event. But then the popularity started really increasing and really ramping up, and these books started really selling, so they decided to start catching up, I guess. In 1965, Asterix and the Banquet, which was the premiere of Dogmatix, and Asterix and Cleopatra were both released. That's impressive. But more impressive, in 1966, while the Beatles were releasing four albums, Asterix had three. Those would be volumes 7, 8, and 9. That's Asterix and the Big Fight, Asterix in Britain, and Asterix and the Normans. In 1 year, three books came out. Now, they obviously didn't draw all three books in the same year. It's a bit of a publishing fluke. But still, when you look at the amount of work that goes into each of those books, each of those 48-page books, it's astounding. And Goscinny and Uderzo were firing on all cylinders at this point in the 60s. And they kept going throughout the 60s and well into the 70s, as a matter of fact, with that. And in the annual releases didn't let up until after Goscinny died and Uderzo took some time off and then eventually picked up the series on his own and released at his own pace over the years. These days, it's a new book every 2 years. But back in the 60s, the Beatles of comics were truly Uderzo and Goscinny doing Asterix. It's a trivial little fact to be sure, but I think it's interesting to note. The sheer amount of pages the two of them did, it was astounding. And Goscinny was writing other series at the same time. Uderzo, at the beginning of Asterix, was doing, I think, two other series at the same time, off and on. So it's an amazing amount of work that has stood the test of time and still sells lots of copies to this day, almost 60 years later.